bring it back. It is 7 o'clock in the Netherlands, straight from the End Groove Remains production team studios in the Netherlands. My name is Mixmaster G and welcome to this live stream. My mission is not to sell you as many apps as I can. No, my mission is to educate and teach you about collection management and conversion for DJs, so you save yourself more time for the fun and creative part of being a DJ. This stream is going to be about Rekordbox and some advanced things within Rekordbox. But that doesn't mean this stream is open for any other questions that are related to collection management and conversion for DJs or macOS tech for DJs in general. Let me quickly introduce myself. My name is Mixmaster G. I'm the man behind the And The Groove Remains production team studios. I call myself a retired DJ because I no longer work actively in clubs or at festivals, etc. However, I like to spin an occasional set, of course, because a DJ heart never dies. I am famous for my tools I develop. The most famous one is the DJ Conversion Utility that allows you to convert tracks from all kinds of DJ software within each other, maintaining your cues and loops. This stream I do every Tuesday around 7 o'clock European time. And feel free to tune in and to chat in because the chats are open on all platforms. This stream is available on Twitch, on YouTube and on Facebook. I prefer Twitch myself because I like that platform a lot for these kind of activities. Sorry. But if you like some other platform, I don't mind. Just ask your question in the chat. I am happy to answer that. DJ Philitel 10, welcome in the house, my friend. Straight from Boston, if I'm not mistaken. Always a pleasure to have you in. First things first, Tiny DJ just released Rekordbox 6.5.1. And of course, everybody happy because this is Big Sur compatible. I still don't understand why you want to be on Big Sur as a DJ, because Big Sur is offering nothing over Mojave or Catalina, otherwise than a head edge. And don't mistake Big Sur compatibility with M1 compatibility. M1 is the new Apple chip, the new Apple CPU in the brand new Apple computers. Those computers run Big Sur as a minimum. You cannot go higher or lower than Big Sur. It's the minimum they require. However, if an app runs on Big Sur, there is no guarantee that it will run on M1. And Rekordbox 6.5.1 is no exception to that rules. Some things might work, other things will not work. So keep in mind that M1 and Big Sur compatibility is not the same. Good evening, my friend Eddie. Nice to have you in the chat and in the stream. Let's move ahead. Rekordbox 6.5.1. Now, this tutorial or this stream will have some things about Rekordbox XML. And to refresh your memory, Rekordbox XML is the Rekordbox way of talking to the outside world, which means usually you cannot dive into a Rekordbox database, not even as a developer. You have to import a Rekordbox XML, and that has all the data, and Rekordbox will translate that to its internal database. And the other way around, if you want to extract queues, loops, and that kind of stuff from a Rekordbox database, you need to make a Rekordbox XML, and that is exactly what an XML is. It's a blueprint, it's a roadmap, JWG. Welcome, my friend. That makes things so much easier if you have that tag. So Rekordbox XML. Now, there is one special thing going on with a Rekordbox XML, and that is that ever since Rekordbox 5.6.0, the import of the Rekordbox XML is bugged in Rekordbox. And let me very quickly show to you what that means. I'm just doing the quick on-screen, off-screen for everybody saying hi. I appreciate you all, so welcome all to the chat. Good to see you all. Another thing, which as the regulars know, often goes wrong, I often forget to switch my screen, because right in front of me, I have my camera and I can see myself. Under there, I have the screen that I share with you. That is what you see right now. But sometimes in all the excitement, I forget to switch the screen. So I think you can see what I'm doing on my screen while you cannot see it, which is of course very stupid, but please scream that in the chat so I can rectify that as quick as possible, so the things I'm telling you make sense. Rekordbox 5.6.1, here we go. Let me first show you, tell you, explain to you what, refresh your memory if you like, what does that Rekordbox XML bug means, because that Rekordbox XML bug can plague you if you are not aware of it. And that is why my apps are so warning about it, that it still exists, and even this version of Rekordbox still has it. All right, right here we've got, let me take the intro tune, and let's give that intro tune just a simple cue. The other track is for the rest of this tutorial. You can already see it. It's coming with tons of cues and loops. We are going to get into that in a moment. We call this cue test. So we have a cue named test right there. Let's make sure that Henry Machina is in the testing playlist. So it is there. And it is just a track with one single cue. And that cue name is test. And especially the name of that cue is important, folks, because that is where things go wrong. I export this in XML format. I name it a Rekordbox. And then we are going to get a little bit technical. Let me double check something else, because otherwise I get a lot of pollution in my Rekordbox collection. That is fine. BPM change points are exported, but I want to know in the analysis that it is back to normal. Yes. Because otherwise I get a lot of beat grid points in my Rekordbox XML, and that's just pollutive. So that's the reason why I wanted to double check before I create the Rekordbox XML. I can even keep Rekordbox open, and let me show you that Rekordbox XML and its contents. And don't worry, I have your hand, so this is going to be pretty simple, because right here you see that new track we just created, and in that track we have the cue name named test. You see it there, name test, and I'm going to change the name test into the name ATGR. So now we have a cue name named ATGR. Same cue, nothing fancy there. The reason why I want to change the name is to show you that those changes are not coming true anymore. That is the essence of the Rekordbox XML bug. And let me show you how that then works. And I know it's boring, and some people know already about the Rekordbox XML bug, but because it keeps coming back, and it is so important that you understand this, because otherwise you think that stuff that Mixmaster G is telling us doesn't work because I tried it exactly as he did and it didn't work. Most likely you are plagued by the Rekordbox XML bug and you can work around it, but you need to be aware of it before you can work around it. I'm going to set the Rekordbox to the Rekordbox XML. That's the one I just modified. I just renamed that queue, remember? And if we go right here to the Rekordbox XML part, and we go to playlists and we go to test, there you see the two tracks. The usual way of importing stuff from a Rekordbox XML is through this. Oh, holy, I almost forgot. Something very important is going to happen. Lucky that I kept it in time. I have to make a backup of my Pioneer collection because that Tiesto track you saw will also be affected by what I'm going to do. And I don't want that. So let me just create a quick backup of my Pioneer folder so I can go back to the way we are right now. Done. Heading back to Rekordbox. Sorry for that, folks, but you have to stay sharp if you're doing this kind of stuff, because otherwise you get lost very easily. And I did prepare that Tiesto track with all those cues and loops. You see them? It's a gazillion of them. Very carefully, and I don't want to lose that preparation. So that's the reason why I wanted to make a backup. Back to the subject. We go to the Rekordbox XML. We right-click playlist and we say import playlist. It tells us that the playlist test already exists. Well, nothing new there because, yes, it exists. And if we go there and we load up that Henry Mancini loop, you see the queue is still named test. This is the Rekordbox bug in full effect, because what should have happened is that the new name was coming with it. And we can get a new name if we do this. If I tell... I didn't have to make a backup because of the Rekordbox, I didn't make to have to make. You see here that song. Now, if I load it from the all tracks part under the XML, let's see if that works. Then we get a warning that it already exists. That's fine. Don't ask again. Go ahead. And then you see the name change to HDR. So, in short, a Rekordbox bug comes down to if a track is already part of the Rekordbox collection, any changes in queues, loops, grid, and other metadata will not make it into the Rekordbox collection. Basically, you're just importing the playlist, but the contents of that playlist are ignored for tracks that are already in the Rekordbox collection. And that is why it's so important, because let's say Serato is your main software where you do your tagging, you set your queues, you do your loops, and you export once a week everything, or you convert once a week everything to Rekordbox, and all of a sudden you don't see all the cues that you changed because you only see them for the new tracks because of the Rekordbox XML bug. So you have to do it in two phases. You have to first import playlists, and then you have to import the all tracks part of the Rekordbox XML. All right, so much for the refreshing of your memory. Let's go to the first subject of this stream, and that first subject is 16 hot cues. Yeah, you hear me correct. 16 hot cues. No, that has really nothing to do with it. JWG, the XML bug was introduced with Rekordbox 5.6.1, which means that Rekordbox 5.6.0 is the last Rekordbox version without the XML import bug, and I'm going to show you all that later on when we go to the second part of this stream, where I'm going to show you how you go from a Rekordbox 6 collection back to a Rekordbox 5 collection, because then it's essential, then it's crucial that you understand what that Rekordbox 6 bug, or what that Rekordbox XML import bug means, because otherwise you cannot go back completely. So that's the reason why. My friend Kevin is in the house. Salute to you, brother. Nice to see you here. And here we go, 16 hot cues. And that is what I created that Tiesto track for. And you can see, oh no, it lost them. It lost them all. It lost them anyway. So what I'm going to do here is going back. I'm going to quit this. And I'm going to restore my backup, because that was the reason that I made that backup in the first place. Very weird. This is new behavior of the XML bug, by the way, for me again, because somehow it was capable of taking the data for the Tiesto track from the XML. So while the Pink Panther team was not affected at all, the other track was. So this is new behavior for the XML bug. Anyway, I can just put that one away, and this is our backup, and then I can fire up Rekordbox, and then I should have my 16 cues. 16 hot cues track from Tiesto. Salute to use yours. Sorry, I saw you a little bit late. Here we go. And oh yeah, there they are. 16 hot cues in full effect. Don't try this at home, folks. You can see 16 hot cues. You only have this in performance mode. If you go to expert mode, then you only see 8 hot cues. I hope it allows me to switch. Yes, it allows me to switch. And we go to the hot cue bank. You see, there you have only those 8 hot cues. However, in performance mode, you all of a sudden have 16 hot cues. And look at those 16 hot cues. There they are. And I named them. I named them hot cue A through K. And as there are some loops in between that are numbered. Please note that the cues are not named A, B, C, D. There are some gaps there because they are named after the pad. They are in, this is at pad F, as you can see. And this is at pad B, as you can see. And this is at pad K, as you can see. Those are 16 hot cues, indeed. Yeah, only in performance mode, very important. Only in performance mode you have those 16 hot cues available to you. Now, thank God, finally DJ gave us back the Rekordbox XML export. However, if you like to use more than 16 hot cues, you have a problem with the XML export, with the import as well. But let's first focus on the export, and let me export this track in XML format. And again, same with Rekordbox, basically making the same XML I just made a moment ago. But who cares? Who's counting? And let me show you the contents of that XML. And I'm going to teach you a little bit of reading an XML file. It's not hard at all. It's very simple to do. But again, it's very important that you understand. You see, this is the Tiesto track. You see it, name is business. And here you see position marks. Position marks are basically cues or loops or bits. But position marks is where the fun is happening. And you see there, name is QA, name is QB, name is QC, D. And then you see loop 1, QF, loop 2, QH. And the rest of those cues are missing. That's right. That's right. For the inizio, you need to indeed learn to speak Italian. That's right, my friend. But you see, there's stuff missing. This XML is not complete. And I made this XML from a Rekordbox collection. Now, who cares, you might think? Well, a lot of people do. Because if we are going to convert, let's say, to Serato, or to Virtual DJ, or to Algorithms DJ, and I'm going to do that in a moment, those apps have separate, let me switch the cam there for a moment, why not? And then you got me, I didn't make that overlay for nothing. If we are going to convert to Serato, Virtual DJ, or Algorithms DJ, those apps have separate hot cue banks and separate loop banks, which means they can store those 16 hot cues easily, because they can cut them up and then you can store them in each other. So it is important that you have that XML complete if you like to use that information. Let me first show you how this works. So we have the XML created in Rekordbox. We have the Tiesto track with a shitload of cues and loops in it. And let me show you what happens if we use the DJ conversion utility to convert that track. By the way, same for the use of the Denon conversion utility. Denon also has 8 hot cue banks and 8 loop banks separate from each other. This works exactly the same, so no change there. And let's wait until it's started up. We come from a Rekordbox XML. You can see right there that the Rekordbox XML is selected. Let me enable. I don't enable Tractor. Why not? Tractor sadly only has 8 hot cue positions, so it doesn't make any sense to convert over to there, because that's not how things works right here. By the way, if you were to use the DJ conversion utility to convert this to Tractor, all what would be left are the hot cues, because the DJ conversion utility prioritizes hot cues over loops. So just that you know. And it should be fairly simple, because there are only 2 tracks in this entire collection. So we can wait for this to finish. You, You're so right, DJ Harless. You're so right. I forgot to switch the screen. Folks, I know, it's annoying, and I will most likely do it again wrong, but the fun part still should become. So here we are. We are in the testing crate, and if you look the business of Tiesto right here, you see that it stops at QH because QH was the last Q. It's A, B, C, D, A, E, F, G, H. The 8Q was the last Q, and it got two of those loops that were in between. And the rest of the information is missing. The same if we, let me quit Virtual DJ. I hate programs that you can't quit with Command Q. Atomics, please fix that. If I press Command Q, you can ask me again if I'm sure, but if I want to quit a program, Command Q is how you do it on an Apple and not going to a menu and then quit. That's so annoying. Serato is equally annoying with the amount of things it asks, but at least it works. And here you can see in, I don't have any audio from now. That's okay. Here you can see it in DJ, same story, 6 cues. And if we go to loops, we have 2 saved loops. Sadly, but true. Then we go to the beta of Serato because I love that beta. The beta is really good. So I really don't use it in a live gig environment, but anything else in the studio, in the lab, just use it because it's a great, I don't know why they made it beta, but they are mostly like me. The moment Serato releases something and deem it beta, that means it's as good as finished, because I also only release betas that are also finished. Same story still. We got 6 cues there and we got 2 loops there. So we are losing a lot of information, and I wasn't really aware of this. First of all, I don't know many people who use over 16 hot cues, but it's possible, so you should be able to use that. And then I wasn't even aware that Rekordbox XML, the Rekordbox XML that the Rekordbox produces, can't contain more than 16 hot or 8 hot cues. So there's a problem there. And then I remembered that before Pioneer DJ had a Rekordbox collection XML export in Rekordbox 6 again, I had to make my own app to export an XML because Rekordbox couldn't export an XML. That was named or is named Rekordbox 6 to XML. I know it doesn't win any prizes for originality. And I thought, what happens if I use 6 to X to create the Rekordbox XML? And I think you can already guess it, because otherwise I wouldn't make this an issue. So let's fire up Rekordbox 6 to X. And 6 to X is bundled with every program of me that works with Rekordbox XML. So that is from the Rekordbox QMK tool to the DJ conversion utility to Denon conversion, to everything that touches on Rekordbox has 6 to X bundled with it. It's in the miscellaneous folder of each app. So find it on the distribution disk image. And let's wait a moment until everything is cleared up. And I don't need to see the log. But of course, because we are all learning Italian now, let's have a look at that particular XML that was produced, and that is this XML that was just produced. If I open it, you can see it already. You've got a QA, B, C, a shitload of queues. Basically, trust me, it are 16 queues and loops. Meaning 6 to X can create an XML that has everything in it. Yep, that's exactly my story, Philip Tan. And there's another reason why you want to use 6 to X. More about that later. First, let me show you how this works. And yes, I would recommend using 6 to X in every situation, because there is something else that is in 6 to X that is in no other XML, and that is right here. That is the mod date, the modification date. And exactly for that modification date, you want to use 6 to X, because that can limit the scope of the tracks you are converting. You see that Pink Panther song I just added later on, you can see it was modified at 6:05. So that's the reason why you want to do it. You want to be sure that you can limit your XML created. More about that later. First, let me show you what the DJ conversion utility will do. If you take the 6 to XML as a source, then convert to, in general, DJ software that has a separate queue and loop bank. So again, we have the Rekordbox XML as a source. You can see right here that the 6 to XML is selected as source. And let's enable everything. Why not? And this won't take long because just a very simple small playlist, of course. At least I did switch the screen this time around, which makes things a little bit easier for us all. Have to wait until everything is finished because that intro Pink Panther track doesn't have everything in it. But here we are again. Yay! And let's load up the Tiesto track. And this time you see we've got right there 8 loops. And we've got, if you go to the hot cue bank, 8 hot cues, which means the whole shitload from Rekordbox is converted to Virtual DJ. Then you have to go to the menu because you cannot command quit it. And there we are. In DJ, same story as you can see. Everything is there. If you go to loops, all your loops are there. And guessed it already, but seeing is believing. Let's do the same thing with right here, Serato. And you see all our loops are there, right here. And all our cues are right there. So that is why I recommend right now always use 6 to X. It's faster, you don't need to open Rekordbox 6, and you don't you basically have some more selection criterion. This is a very tiny Rekordbox collection, so it really doesn't matter if I want to limit the scope by the modification date, because only tracks from today are in it. But if you want to use 6 to X, you can press the command key on your keyboard, and if you open it then, let me show that to you. Why not? Not sure if it's command or one of the other. It's one of the others. And it's either control or option. Don't know. Let me find out. Find me the option key. Nope, that one. There you are. If you hold down the option, the alt key, then you get this dialog where you can enter the modification date of the tracks, and only tracks you have modified at or after that date will be in the XML. There won't be any playlist, it will be a flat playlist with the modification date selection. But this is very powerful if you do your basic DJ preparation in Rekordbox and you want to convert only the tracks you have worked on to, let's say, Engine Prime, or you want only the tracks you have worked on to Serato, then you just create a very tiny, very quickly to convert XML. And that's the reason why 6 to X is also very useful. Now I hear you think, hey Mixmaster G, but what about importing the XML? I have to say I'm sorry, because importing the XML in Rekordbox is also limited to 8 hot cues. I can demonstrate that. Let me show that as well. So let's go to Rekordbox and let's point Rekordbox, or it should actually be looking already at the 6 to X Rekordbox XML. Then we have to work around, of course, the Rekordbox 6 bug. Let me double check that indeed it's looking at the right one. Yeah. Let's go right here. I do this the safe way, which is just go to the old track segment. The playlist is already there. Select them all. Import to collection, like that. Don't ask me again. They are imported. And right now you can see it happening already. That Tiesto track is limited again. It only got 8 hot cues and the rest is gone. So importing Rekordbox XML is also risky. So this isn't for everybody. Not many people I know are going over 8 hot cues, especially because the gear, the CDJ, etc., is not capable of that. Let me show that as well. In that case, I have to restore my Rekordbox collection again to the full version. I hope I did save it. Did I save it? No, I didn't save it. All right, then I have to go deep, because we at the and the Groove Remains production team studio, on average, know pretty good what we are doing. So I can just restore one of the internal backups, which is always a little bit tricky. So don't do this with your golden current Rekordbox XML or a current collection, because this can be a little bit tricky, but sometimes it works, you see. We are up and running again. Here we've got, again, that track with 16 hot cues. And let me get a USB out, because I have a Nexus 2 rig right at my disposal, so I can show you what's going on there as well. Here we've got the test. Delete the tracks that are on there to avoid any confusion. Then just take the Tiesto track and put it in all tracks. Yeah, that's fine, go ahead. Let's wait for it to fully synchronize. It and then load this version. Mind you, I'm looking at the USB drive. If I load it from the USB drive, I still got my shitload of cues, which means that information is exported to a CDJ USB. It is actually on the CDJ USB. And let me eject this and then switch the camera once again. There we are. And here we've got our little USB. Hello, the track. And I'm not sure if it is visibly, so let's see if I can a little bit. You can see it only shows 8 hot cues again. We know, because we saw that already from Rekordbox, that it contains 16 hot cues, but it shows only 8 hot cues. So the CDJ 2000 doesn't have that. I've checked with Rekordbox, the CDJ 3000 only is also limited to 8 hot cues as well. And there is no modifier key that you go to the next bank, because on my CDJ 2000, of course, I only have out again. I only have 4 hot cues, and then we have the modifier key to change the bank. So you change the bank, and I thought that maybe something similar would be available on the CDJ 3000. That is not the case. There is no modifier key. Now my contact at Pioneer is looking into the fact if maybe the XP2, that is the big USB device. Let me show that to you, guys. I don't have it over here, but let me show what the XP2 is all about. Because maybe with the XP2 you can go over 8 hot cues. We are not sure about that, so he is looking into that. Pioneer XP2. Quickly see what we can come up with. Then switch the screen again. Why not? Always forget that. So there we are. That's the XP2. Most likely with the XP2, you can go over 8 hot cues, but we are not sure. So I will come back to that. And talking about coming back to that, 2 weeks from now, that is Tuesday the 16th, my big friend Jeroen Groenendijk, that is the product specialist at Pioneer DJ Europe, will be over with me right here in the ATR studios to talk about stuff, everything Pioneer DJ. We have one topic in mind already, that is how the MyTags work in Rekordbox, because those are very powerful if you want to create a conditional playlists, also known as smart playlists. So we will dive into that, but we are happy to answer each and every question available. And Jeroen will take the XP2 with him if he can find it, because he needed to dust it off. So we hope that we can then answer, can we go over 8 hot cues in a live performance situation using the XP2. I'm not sure about the XP1, Eddie. Jeroen, I'm not very familiar with the XP range of products from Pioneer at all. I'm more with the mixers and the CDJs. However, Jeroen will look into it and will give me a definite answer about it. So we hope we can tell more about that. But until then, in live situation, it's not possible. I think some of the controllers have modified keys that you can go over 8. But of course, controllers are great. Let's not forget that. But that's not what you want to use in most booth situations. Then you find CDJs, and in case you use more than those 8 hot cues, then you want to use them, right? Because you didn't set them for nothing. No, 62X is strictly Rekordbox 6, because let's talk about that a little bit. When Rekordbox 6 came out, Pioneer DJ took away the XML export. Nobody knows why. They never gave me an answer why, and trust me, I've asked, but they took it away, which is a problem for many DJs. So I created 62X to make it possible to have an XML export from Rekordbox 6 again. Rekordbox 6 and Rekordbox 5 use entirely different collection databases. They are not even close to the same thing. Rekordbox 6 uses SQLite as its database, where Rekordbox 5 uses something that is called Device SQL, which is proprietary stuff and not very easy to work with. So this is strictly 62X, strictly Rekordbox 6 only. And I already touched on this. Rekordbox 6 and Rekordbox 5 don't use the same database. However, all versions of Rekordbox 5 use the same database, which means, and that is why I promote that so often, you can use Rekordbox 5.6.0 to import XML, because Rekordbox 5.6.0 is the last version that doesn't have the Rekordbox XML import bug. And then you can do your real work in Rekordbox 5.8.5, because Rekordbox 5.8.5 can access the database that Rekordbox 5.6.0 imported the XML data in. This is important later on in the stream, where we are going from Rekordbox 6 to Rekordbox 5 back in time. While I have the CDJ right here, there is another thing that was popping up again in on Reddit today, and that is hot cue behavior on a CDJ. This is a CDJ 2000 Nexus 2, but this works the same with every CDJ out there. So it's not only the Nexus 2, the CDJ 2000 has it too. If you come from a controller situation, then you are used to something that is called gated hot cues behavior. Let me show you first what that is on the screen right here. Gated hot cues basically comes down to the fact that, let me double check if I'm gated right here, because it is an option. I always have to look where that option is, because it's pretty much hidden, but let's hope that we are in gated mode. If not, then I have to switch it, and then I have to find it. No, it's in, right now it's not in views either. All right, well, if I'm not in gated, then I will find it, otherwise. But I am in gated. This is gated hot cue behavior. That means that the moment you click the hot cue, it will play for as long, the track will play for as long as you hold the hot cue. If you release the hot cue, then it's gone again. So that's gated hot cue behavior. Then the opposite to gated hot cue behavior is non-gated hot cue behavior. Is it under the controller tab, Philip 10? All right, let's find it. I thought it must be somewhere there. Let's see, hot cue behavior, there you are. This one, hot cue. And it says during pause, gate playback is applied. So that's exactly what's happening here. If a track is paused, if a track is loaded in the deck, and you press the hot cue, It will play for as long as you press it, and the moment you release the hot cue, it stops playing. Exactly what you are used in Serato, in Traktor. You can set it as an option on the Denon Prime gear. Algorithms DJ works this way. If you come from a controller base, this is what you are used. The first time I ever was working with CDJs, and I come from a Traktor background, and of course I played always vinyl and stuff like that, but the first time I had to spin digitally on a CDJ coming from a Traktor background, I scared the shit out of myself, because what was happening was this. Show that. So I had this track load up, and I like to just tap a little bit on the beat of the track to get a hang of it. So I tapped on the first one, and what was happening was exactly this. The track starts playing. The moment you tap a hot cue, the track will start playing, and it will continue to play regardless. It will continue to play. So hot cues always act non-gated on a CDJ. Now here you think, hey, Mixmaster G, but it's very easy to make an option on that player. The same we have in Rekordbox, that you can say gated, non-gated. I have very long discussions with the engineering team of Pioneer DJ about this, because I'm with you guys. It's very easy to make it, but their theory is that, listen, artists that are now used to the way our hot cues work cannot work if that is switchable, because that has a risk. The same risk that got me scared shitless the moment I was there. I fired up my first hot cue only to find that it was starting the track in the opposite direction. So that's the reason why they don't want to change it yet. I hope maybe some changes might be coming, but they're not changing it that bad. Does that mean that you don't have any option to make hot cues there? No, there is an option to do that, and that option is memory cues, and that's the reason why I always provide memory cues in the conversions. I set both hot cues and memory cues, because you can make memory cues act as a hot cue. Let me show that to you quickly again. Oh, that's Biggie. That's me again. Let me get that USB, and let's give the Tiesto track a memory cue. And then let me show you how you can mimic hot cue behavior on a CDJ using memory cues. It is loaded, and then I want to go back to, hold on, because otherwise I have to switch those banks, and that's always annoying. There we are, memory cue, and let's that one, and just set memory cue there, memory. MQ, and let's set one by the low track as well. The memory, don't you memory? And we know we call that low track. You can see that I'm used to the fact that those things are usually converted, so I don't have to set them manually. Another thing, you can set colors here. That color information is not exported to XML, is not imported from XML. So that is very important to understand. Let me put this on test. Vitel, I see your remark. I will get there when I'm through with this stuff. Let me put the Tiesto track on there. Famous warning. Always double check if what you have done is indeed set on the USB, and indeed that's on the USB. So like that, and then again, okay, and let's switch our cam. There we are, and we are again, and then we've got now our memory cues, and I can toggle which one I want to load. So I just recalled a memory cue, and let me zoom out a little bit so you can see what's going on, because you need to have the screen there. There we are. Perfect mess. All right, so I have the memory cue loaded up, and if I use this cue button, get down. That is exactly the same way that your gated hot queue behaves. So the combination of loading a memory queue with those two, so you have the proper memory queue, another one, got two set, and there you can use it exactly as you are used to. So this one, and of course if you want to play it continuous, you play a little bit with it and then you hold it and then you press the play button and it will continue to play exactly what you are used on Serato or on any other controller like stuff. Really, then the S11 is of course an entirely different beast. The S11 is not your average CDJ USB mixer. No, it's a Serato device. It's really, of course, it works with the Rekordbox, but let's face it, if you are into turntablism, then Serato is usually your weapon of choice. And that means that things like legacy problems, etc., are no longer in play. That just needs to be the coolest mixer with all the nifty features, including silent queue, gated queue, non-gated queue, etc. And you can do that with an S11 because that is intended for an entirely different crop of DJs. The CDJ DJs are not into that much of the technology anymore. They just want CDJs and play their shit and that's it. It's like the old VHS Betamax Wars. Betamax was technically more advanced, had the better quality, had the more features. But VHS simply won because Sony refused to have porn on Betamax, so, or on VHS. So that's the reason why VHS won over Betamax. And the same thing here. It's for an entirely different crop of people using it with a different means. So yeah, they have gated queues, and on CDJs they are non-gated queues, and that is not going to change anytime soon. From the looks of it, I wish it was different because I would love to see that change. All right, the next thing we were going to discuss is going back from a Rekordbox 6 collection to a Rekordbox 5 collection. And maybe you can already taste it, maybe you can already feel it. It's highly in the air how to do that. Let me switch my cam again. There we are. Because you use the XML for that. So I've got my Rekordbox 6 collection right here, and I want to have that Rekordbox 6 collection in you want to have that Rekordbox 6 collection in Rekordbox 5. You can either export the collection in XML format, because you are going to import it again. This is not going to be a base of conversion. This is going to be imported again. It really doesn't matter if we go above 8 or not hot queues, because importing the XML will always go below 8 hot queues, so that doesn't matter. I could just export this to Rekordbox, to an XML place, and then I can leave Rekordbox 6. And here comes the thing. I've got two versions of Rekordbox on my computer. If I go to applications, you find right here Rekordbox 5.6.0 and Rekordbox 5. Rekordbox 5 contains Rekordbox 5.8.5, which is the last available Rekordbox version. And Rekordbox 5.6.0 is the last Rekordbox version that was without the Rekordbox XML bug. Let me show you the difference. If I fire up Rekordbox 5, it really doesn't matter which version I get. You will see the XML is empty. See, or the collection is empty. There's nothing there. And that is for both versions, because those versions are looking at the same Rekordbox collection. They are using the same database. So I can fire up Rekordbox 5.6.0. And you see the exact same database and always the annoying message that there is an update. Now let me import the XML in that empty Rekordbox 5.8.5 collection, because we don't care that it's empty, and as long as a track is not in the XML, is not in the collection, the XML bug won't haunt us. DJ Philippel, I see your question. I get into that in a minute. Otherwise, this gets so messy. So I try to have a little bit kind of a structure in this stream that really works. Go to the preferences and switch the Rekordbox XML to the Rekordbox XML I just exported. And then it's straightforward. Go to another Rekordbox, right click, import playlist. And if you go there, you see that everything is there. Oh, this is a serious bug. This is a serious bug what you see right now. I hope you guys catch this. You see that Tiesto is double there. I've warned Pioneer about this behavior, and this is another problem of a Rekordbox generated XML. I show you where it's coming from. And it's a bug. It's a bug, but the thing is, that bug only plagues you if you go back to Rekordbox 5. Within Rekordbox 6, you can import this XML and it looks fine. Let me show you that. Why not? And with my tools, you can use that XML and it will work fine because the XML is properly structured. The XML is a valid XML. It's simple. So if I go right here and let's set it to the Rekordbox XML. So Philippe, I just gave you a third reason why you want to go use 6.2x, but this is a different story. And then we go to that playlist. There you see both tracks right there, no problem. Which is different from what you saw a moment ago in Rekordbox 5. It's a little bit going back and forth, folks. I'm sorry. That's the reason why I keep the collections on this computer or on this account very small. Because then I can quickly go back and forth. No reason to apologize, Philippe. I appreciate your question, so no worries. You see, that's the same XML. Why is this happening? Well, if you look inside the XML, right there, and look at this thing, track ID, you see a ridiculous high number. Apparently, and you see that number there too, track ID, apparently Rekordbox 5 cannot handle those ridiculous high over 6-digit numbers. That's the reason why it's basically locking up. Now let me show you again what happens if you use a 6.2x produced Rekordbox XML. I forgot about this one, so it's a third reason. As you can see, Rekordbox and XMLs, it's a blessing that it exists, but it isn't an ideal marriage there. All right, we have created the Rekordbox 6 XML. Let me fire up Rekordbox again. If we now look at the preferences, then you can see that the Rekordbox 6 is automatically selected. 6.2x takes care of that, so that's the easy part. If you then look right there, you see that this is properly formatted. That will import just fine. So back to where we were, let's import this one. And there you've got both tracks there. Now again, if I change something in the XML, if I change something in the original record, let me do all the steps. Let me give the Pink Panther loop track an extra loop. Because then you see clearly what that XML bug is again. I know I'm pressing on that XML bug, but it's so important that you understand that it's there and that it is a problem. Panther team there, and we give it extra loop there. That's it. I'm not going to export the collection from XML because that XML will be garbage for Rekordbox 5 anyway. I'm going to use the 6.2x tool to produce that XML. Now, if you don't use my tools and you want to do this trick, that means you have to manually edit the XML and make those IDs lower, because that's the whole problem there. And let me fire up Rekordbox again. Mind you, this is going to Rekordbox 5.8.5, so I'm... Oh, it's not, it's Rekordbox 5.6. Let me start up Rekordbox 5.8.5, because I want you to see and understand what the Rekordbox XML import box means. So we know that the Pink Panther team has, right now, an extra loop. So if I go to Rekordbox XML and I right-click and say Import Playlist, it tells us that stuff already exists, and we go there and we load it up. You see, we don't have the loop there. Let me do the exact same procedure in Rekordbox 5.6.0. So I don't change anything. Of course, you can avoid it by going the two steps, but this is easier because it's one step. And to be honest, Rekordbox 5.6.0 is the snappiest of the bunch, is the fastest of the bunch. I go back to my playlist, right-click import playlist. It already exists. Yeah, we know it's importing. And if you look right now, you see that the loop is imported. This is exactly the XML import bug in effect. 5.6.0 is fine. 5.8.5 is not fine. Now, if I quit 5.6.0 and I start up 5.8.5, and there we go, then you can see that indeed the loop has arrived because they are both looking at the exact same database. So I hope it's clear that you can't go back from Rekordbox 6 to Rekordbox 5. There is an issue there with the Rekordbox formatted XML file, which have those very high ID numbers, and those need to be scaled back in order for it to work. You can do it by using 6.2x. That is your best bet, because then you get a perfectly formatted XML that will be imported in Rekordbox just fine. Then I'm going to look what Philip Ten had to say. I agree wholeheartedly with you. That is funny to see that. But let's face it. Turntablists are geeks by definition. They really love technology. They just like the mechanics of working with vinyl and how that all works. But they do tricks that you cannot do on a CDJ, which are impossible to do in a CDJ. So yeah, I understand what you're saying. I hear what you're saying. And indeed, if you think about it from that perspective, it is funny. On the other hand, the turntablists that I know take a Qbert who designs its own computer, for God's sake. Jesse Jeff is a real geek who loves technology, all kind of technology. Scratch Bested really, really, really loves technology. So all those real turntablists also have a great love for technology, even more than the regular CDJ USB DJ. And I don't mean that disrespectful, it's just to make the distinction there. This also is so do I, being proud to be a geek. But well, it isn't for everybody, because some people just want to be cool, and let's face it, we will never be cool, so I don't even try to be cool. I don't care. That's the difference. These were all the subjects I wanted to speak with you guys about and wanted to show you. If there are questions, this is the time that you can drop them in the chat, and I'll be very happy to address them. Like I said, 2 weeks from now, I have my buddy Jeroen Groenendijk over from Pioneer DJ, and he will talk with me about all things Pioneer, and you can really ask him anything. If it comes to Rekordbox, we are about on the same level of knowledge. But if you talk about hardware, then he far exceeds me about what he knows about the DJM, whatever, etc., etc. Just drop your questions or make sure you leave them in the comments. Phil Ten, thank you for attending, buddy. Good to have you around. Always nice to have some interaction going. I really appreciate it. And next week, I will be here by myself, of course, working things I have collected over the week. I do these AMAs each Tuesday, 7 o'clock Central European time. That's Amsterdam time, that's Leiden time, that is Paris time. Make your pick which city you like, but it's the European continent time. And I welcome everybody who is interested in this stuff to join it. And especially if you've got questions, just leave them in the chat, and I'm very happy to address those questions. And you have seen right now, I show you stuff, I make things as clear as possible. And if it's not clear, just feel free to ask me again, because I'm happy to do that over again. If you think that what I'm doing is useful and interesting, please give this video the thumbs up. If you've got questions for next sessions, leave them in the remarks right below. Thank you all very much for watching and for attending the stream. Mixmaster G signing off.